Hey everybody, welcome back to another video. Tonight we're going to be testing out a new gadget that I just got. This is the Celestron NexYZ. This is a three-axis smartphone holder that allows you to take afocal shots using the eyepiece. And pretty much you just put your phone in the front pad here. You take these two knobs, you can adjust the different parameters here, and then also the distance of the eyepiece this way. So you have three axis adjustment, and then you can configure where your phone sits in relation to the eyepiece, focus it up really nice and get some really good photos. So we're gonna test this out. This is the first light. I just unboxed it about 20 minutes ago. Right now it's retail for about $75, but Amazon I was able to get it for $55 with a little bit of a coupon and then also a sale they were running. So if you ever get them on sale, they're actually a pretty good buy. But we're gonna try to hook this up to just one of my small telescopes, see if we can take a shot of the full moon tonight since it is full moon, and then maybe try it on a deep sky object or two. I don't have extremely high expectations, but you never know. It could actually prove to be quite a winner. So let's get started. Installation of this should be pretty simple. You just wrap this around one of your eyepieces. This one may actually be too big, this Explore Scientific one. Nope, there we go. And you tighten this bolt all the way so you can't tighten it inward so you can't, so it doesn't come out of alignment for you. Just like that. You take your phone, now this is using the newer iPhone 11 Pro, so you can see we can adjust the field of view here a little bit, and there the moon comes into the field of view of our camera chip. We just adjust that accordingly. So how this works here is once you have your phone installed into the cradle here, you're going to take the two knobs on the bottom here. And you can see as we move this back and forth, this is the reflection right here of the eyepiece that we're going back and forth on right there. And so what you want to do is you want to kind of line it up like that, and then take the next one and kind of move it up and down again. So you see right about there, let's move it to the left, we're going the wrong way, so we'll go to the right a little bit. And there's our full moon. And what we can do is from here, we can, you know, tap on it, maybe decrease the exposure a little bit. And you see, up a little bit too much there. But like there, we can take a photo based off that. I like to put it on a timer as it is just a hair unstable sometimes. But now we can go to our photos and see that we just captured this beautiful image of the full moon here. Even with just this little smartphone adapter and this little 4-inch telescope. So far, this is actually really, really awesome. Now, if you're using a newer version of the iPhone, like this is the iPhone 14, you can set this to Apple RAW, which means then you'll get a full 48 megapixel instead of a crop down 12 megapixel, which will give you a much more clearer image. And I'll try to take a few RAW photos here as well. Let's turn on the RAW mode. And even though it's probably not going to make too much of a difference just right off the bat for us, in the end, with the total 48 megapixel, then it will make a difference for us. So here's the Apple RAW image, and you can see there's a lot of nice detail here on this photo. So this is very, very promising for astrophotography from your front yard. Now I think we're going to head over to Jupiter, see if we can try something on Jupiter, and then maybe also a deep sky object like the Pleiades. We've aligned the NexYZ on Jupiter, and I've added my 3x lens using the iPhone 14. And you can see this is the live video that's coming off, and you can see the cloud belts there of Jupiter. And again, we're going to take a little bit of just a timer exposure just to see what it looks like. But certainly for sure, you can, with even this little tiny little device and your iPhone or any smartphone even capture a photo with Jupiter's bands, and there's two of the moons right here off to the side. So far, 2 out of 2. We are officially on test number 3 of 3, and this is showing a deep sky target. This is a live view of the double cluster in Perseus. Now, I know there's these grids along the screen here, but these are just preferences in iPhone that you can set, or whatever smartphone you have. But you can see NGC 869 and 884, those are the two of the double cluster right there in the field of view. And I just took one of these photos with a 5-minute exposure, and you can see very clearly you have both the double cluster. It's a little bit out of focus. There's a little bit of distortion because this is a small telescope and these eyepieces maybe aren't the best. But that is pretty impressive. Now, I did take a shot of the Pleiades just a moment ago. Now, that was using the 3x zoom there. This was using the 1x zoom. And even with the 1x zoom, it went away there. Even with the 1x zoom, you can easily get the double cluster right there in the center and the whole expansive field of view around it, which I think is really great. I also took a shot of the Pleiades, like I said. You can kind of make out the Pleiades here on the screen, the shape of the Pleiades here, and the surrounding star cluster. I'll show the actual pictures at the end of this video, just so you can kind of get an idea. But even for basic astrophotography, it does work, and it works very, very well. So I give it a huge thumbs up. So just some final words on the Celestron NEXYZ. This is a absolutely fantastic beginner astrophotography sort of device here that you can take pictures of the moon, the planets, bright deep sky objects if your phone supports night mode, and you can use it on a variety of eyepieces. Now, this contraption does come with two separate little adapter pieces, and they go around the eyepieces. If your eyepiece has a real thin barrel to it for the body, you will have to use one of those to basically bulk it up enough for this clamp to hold on nice and secure. If your eyepiece is real thin, this clamp will not tighten all the way. So once you're done clamping your eyepiece, you tighten this orange knob right here, spin it in towards the device. That locks this tab, so if you try to push this for the clamp, it won't come undone on you. Now, the Explore Scientific eyepieces are always been quite beefy. These do support up to certain 2-inch eyepieces, so you can use a nice wide field eyepiece and an SCT or something. The only thing I don't really like is it's a great device. It's got great ergonomics to it. These knobs are really easy, even with gloves on, I imagine, and everything's really easy to find. The only thing I don't like is when you have a heavy phone right here, the mechanism, the little gear that controls your distance from the eyepiece, that also controls this axis, has a tendency to wobble. You can see that the eyepiece is perfectly steady, but yet my unit, at least, is very loose here. Now I'm gonna see if there's anything that I can do to try to tighten this up. But when you have a big, heavy phone, it causes the image, instead of being perfectly circular for your camera, it causes an offset where on mine, the circle was down towards the bottom of the phone. So I don't know if this is a defect that a lot of them have, or if it's just my unit, but that would be the only thing that I kind of am a little iffy about. But overall, it absolutely works fantastic, and I think for the price, it turns your telescope, whatever it may be, into a great beginner's astrophotography setup. And I think that that's something really cool and awesome to bring to this exciting hobby. Thanks for joining me. I hope you stick around. I have lots of new content coming soon. Clear skies to you, and enjoy.